sound. Half in hopeless sorrow and half in fear that they would find the soldiers breaking through and drag us all away. Just before the sunrise, I heard something at the wall. The gate began to rattle and the voice began to call. I hurried to the window, looked down into the street, expecting swords and torches and the sound of soldiers' feet. There was no one there but Mary, so I went down to let her in. And John stood there beside me as she told us where she had been.
They woke in the night, and none of us knows who. Stones been pulled away.
Stone and the empty tomb, just the way that Mary said. But the winding sheet they wrapped him in was just an empty shell. And how or where they had taken him was more than I could tell. Something strange happened there, just what I did not know. John believed the miracle, but I just turned to go. Circumstance and speculation lift me very high. I had seen them crucify him, and I saw him die. Back inside the house again, the guilt and anguish came. Everything I had promised him just added to my shame. When at last it came to choice, I had denied I knew his name. And even if he were alive, I know it wouldn't be the same. Suddenly the air was filled with strange, sweet perfume. Light that came from everywhere, drove the shadows from the room. And Jesus stood before me with his arms held open wide. I fell down on my knees and I clung to him and cried. Confusion disappeared in sweet release, and every fear I'd ever had just melted into peace. He's alive. He's alive. He's alive.